Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. We were sent to appeal to contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
obrzezania nic nie znaczy ani nie obrzezania, tylko nowe stworzenie. Na wszystkich tych, którzy się tej zasady trzymać będą i na Izraela Bożego niech stąpi pokój i miłosierdzie. Odtąd niech już nikt nie sprawia mi przykrości. Przecież ja na ciele swoim noszę bliskie znamię przynależności do Jezusa. Łaska Pana naszego, Jezusa Chrystusa, niech będzie z duchem waszym, bracia. Amen. Oto słowo Boże.
I've got a big mouth, so I'm going under the assumption that you can hear me. Okay? It's so good to see young people. Gotcha. you than I am. It's so good. I was talking to someone in the sacristy. I had 5 o'clock minutes at St. Stanislaus last night. And I was talking to someone in the sacristy. And we were saying how difficult it is to do. How much road rage have you experienced? Have gone and cursed you out for any little thing that happens. Sad yesterday, or was it Friday? We had a problem in that. What was it? Texas. 19 kids, 19 babies were killed. And the list didn't go on. What does Jesus say today? When you go into a house as a follower of Jesus, what are the first words out of your mouth? Peace to this house. Peace. And that is the focus of the Catholic Christian. Glory, because it isn't. Anyone who thinks that is a little bit of no good but convincing. You understand what I'm saying? But peace means right relationship. You may not agree with me. That doesn't make any difference. If we are at peace with each other, that's the important thing. You don't have to like me, but to be at peace with me is the important thing. But how does that happen? The next important virtue, if peace is an important virtue in the life of a Christian, the second virtue is just as important, if not more important. And that is patience. And if you notice today, that is not very often the case either. How can a person be at peace if they are not patient with others and with themselves? and with themselves. There's no sense in talking about patience or peace with other people if one is not patient or at peace with oneself. That means you have to forgive yourself as much as you have to forgive others. Right? That's what the Lord is talking to us today. Because, dearly beloved, if we are going to go out and proclaim Jesus out there, and don't forget, it's your responsibility too. If we're going to proclaim Jesus out there, then we have to be patient and we have to be full of peace. Or peaceful. And we have to be patient and at peace with ourselves. And I'm repeating that because that is important. We have to be patient and at peace with ourselves. If you can't do that, then you might as well forget the whole show. We have to be patient and at peace with ourselves, and then be patient and at peace with others. How important that is. Let us pray. Let us truly pray. And work for that patience and that peace. Because if we are patient and if we are at peace, then we will truly proclaim the gospel. Oh, by the way, proclaiming the gospel is not by you getting on a soapbox and talking to people. You and I proclaim the gospel by our actions. We need to do this. So especially on these days in which we are reflecting upon our freedom, our liberty, and all the gifts that God has given to us in this country. Let us pray especially for peace, which the world cannot give. Only He can give peace. But patience, which is the prelude to peace for ourselves and for others. I believe in one God.
Amen. Things are called the invisible. God substantial with the Father, through Him all things for me, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, He was crucified in the precious body. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. Amen. proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son being glorified, and spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come.
With faith and confidence, let us bring our prayers to the Lord.
For our church, may the Lord raise up holy men and women to humbly labor on her behalf. Let us pray to the Lord. For civil leaders, may the Lord guide them in their work promoting justice, peace, and truth. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who are sick in this faith community, may God restore them to the fullness of life and health, liberate them from all that afflicts them. Let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved deceased, remembering especially today Jim Arbuchowski, may they come to share in the fullness of Christ's glory and enjoy his favor forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
oblation dedicated to your name, purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the light of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always endeavoring to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom we made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. The mystery of faith. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, grant us peace in our day, and in you, and that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you. Thank you. 2 days later, delegates from the 13 colonies adopted the Declaration of Independence, an historic document drafted mainly by Thomas Jefferson. From 1776 to the present day, July 4th has been celebrated as the birth of American independence, with festivities running from fireworks, gatherings, barbecues, his family gatherings, but also in respect of those who gave their life in this country, of those people who wanted freedom. And the American Revolution is different than the Soviet Revolution, different than the French Revolution, because the American Revolution had God. They asked for the protection of God, where the other revolutions, they were anti-God. And that's why we are in an important period of time in this nation, when God is attacked, family is attacked, but the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, is under the name of God, and we in the United States will endure. American virtue, red, white, and blue, patriotic ways, flying over glory, grateful for freedom, thankful for those who sacrificed the ultimate price, leaving behind their families to embrace our country's safety. Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.